One of our stars today, Adrian Gonzalez, trying to contain him, not easy. Great to play here at home today, the Los Angeles Dodgers. They get to do just that. Thank you for joining us, Major League Baseball, presented by 2K Sports, Thursday afternoon game. We're going to see Josh Beckett start. So, Steve, how's he going to handle these San Francisco bats today?
I think the key for Josh Beckett is he has to use both his four-seam and his two-seam fastball. If he gets locked in on one, it makes it that much easier on the hitters.
Let's see what Bruce Bochy's got going here in the lineup. Scouting pick, John, who are we looking at today?
Well, Pablo Sandoval is a guy you need to keep your eye on. He's an exciting hitter, and by that I mean it doesn't matter where the pitch is, he's hacking at it. Anything that moves forward, he's going to put a swing on it. Usually, he puts it in play.
Play ball. Time to get rolling here with Angel Pagan. Beckett finds the strike zone. It's in there for a strike.
Now, if I'm batting right here, I know the pitcher's tendencies. In the scouting report, I'm looking for a fastball in the 0-1 count.
Couldn't pull the trigger in time. He's behind 0-2. Change up, he bounced that one to the catcher. Here's the pitch. Swing and a liner to right center. Well, that's a good start. First batter, first hit. Now we'll take a quick look at the Dodgers and see what they look like defensively. Highlights, John, from these fielders.
Hanley Ramirez is one of the bigger shortstops in the game of baseball. What he possesses, though, is a great athleticism with that unbelievable throwing arm.
And we're going to see Scudero here. In his career, 6-for-15 off Beckett.
And just take a look at their history, and he's just owned everything the righty has offered up at the plate.
Swung on, hit by Scudero. Crawford's there as he gets to it for the out. Sandoval at the plate.
You know, there were a number of factors in why the Dodgers weren't able to catch up for the Giants or get even a wild card spot last year, but really the one that sticks out to me is how poorly they played within the NL West.
Pagan's at first. Strike one to Sandoval. And as Steve said, the record for the Dodgers in the West, 35-37. A lot of those losses coming at the hands of the Giants, their great opponent, John.
Well, and that's why the Giants ended up running away with that division, because they did handle the Dodgers pretty easily in 2012. This is a different Dodger team, though, 2013. I think it might have a chance of playing out a little bit differently.
And Sandoval, another foul ball. At the belt, Beckett kicks, throws towards center field. Kemp will field. And he grabs it in his tracks.
Good pitch right there. Got the hitter a little bit out on his front foot. Easy fly ball to center field.
And with two down, it'll be Buster Posey. He's got a 292 average when going up against the Dodgers.
Keep an eye on him over there, Beckett.
Swings on that first pitch, misses the fastball, 0-1.
That's a huge swing right there. He was looking for a fastball, but just couldn't quite catch up to it. Great pitch.
There's a swing and a ground ball.
Well, sometimes you pay the price for a mistake pitch. That's what that one was there, guys, right down the middle.
Yeah, he just lined that thing, lined it up when he saw it was right in the wheelhouse. Great job of hitting.
And the next batter, Gary, will probably not see a pitch that easy to hit.
Hunter Pence in the box. Gone 6 out of 14 against Beckett. Posey is on at first. Pagan at second. And Beckett can't get him to swing at that low pitch.
Hey, man, that was a close one right there. He drilled that fastball in nice and low, just a hair too low. Give the hitter credit for laying off that one.
Cutter just off the black, and he falls behind 2-0. The pitch. Hit foul off the bat of Pence. Here's a spin and a throw back to second. A dive, and he's back in easily. Now Beckett sets up 2-1. There's a swing and a liner. And that's a base hit. Pence on at first. Pagan scores.
Well, what a great piece of hitting right there and a big RBI. You put your team in the lead, and a lot of times it's too much for the other team to overcome.
So looking to capitalize on this RBI chance, here is Brandon Belt. What we're seeing here is just a great push. They've been able to jump out in front here in this ball game. You'll have to get the other team down early.
Well, this game may very well turn out to be a high-scoring game. First inning, we've already got good production.
And Beckett, no luck with that pitch up the ladder. You know, the story production, as John alluded to a moment ago, how many times do you see the team who gets on the board first, capture that energy, and just run with it?
Well, Gary, you hope to do that exactly right. Build on the confidence in your lineup, stay focused, and allow your pitcher to be aggressive as well. It's exactly the formula for winning.
Comes set, now the 2-0. Ball three, Brandon Belt does not go after it, and now in danger of walking him. Lifetime, he's just 185 off the Dodgers.
And it just seems like there's always that one team that you struggle against, and this happens to be the team for him.
And now Brandon Belt, and he has the 3-1 count.
Well, that cut fastball away, it looks like it's coming down the heart of the plate, runs to the outside corner. It tends to turn into a pop-up.
Here's the pitch. Swung on, a drive by Belt. And that is gone. San Francisco keeps pouring it on. Now they lead by 4, a 3-run homer. Probably thinking about the matchups here as we check the bullpen, left-handers throwing.
Oh, that's right. I think they're getting them loosened up to face the hitter in the on-deck circle.
Let's look at how that 3-run shot affects their chances. Chance at a victory charted on our WPA graph.
We've seen this guy do this in batting practice, but to translate it into a game situation, that's talent.
Now, I guarantee you after this game, they'll have the tape measure out just to make sure how far this one was really hit.
He just obliterated that ball. For the Giants, they've shown what they're capable of, and right now, this is just stat padding time. I don't see them getting caught in this one.
And Beckett gets him swinging on that first strike.
Now, they're not wasting any time today. They're coming out strong in the first and making a serious statement.
What a way to start this ball game. You got a chance to put this thing away maybe very early.
Now, they showed up to play. There's no question about it. They want to get up early and try to run away with it.
That one taken by Crawford for a strike.
Oh, what a tough first inning right here. Up over 20 pitches and really having some issues with his control.
Crawford will file that one away. Beckett kicks and throws. And another foul ball.
Well, the pitcher did exactly what he wanted to do on that 0-2 count. He wanted him to swing the bat, and he did, but he just fouled it off. Great piece of hitting.
Grounded to Gonzalez. It's scooped up, and he'll step on first to retire the side. Well, that's the kind of first inning you want. Big early runs. The Giants on top, 4-0. San Francisco starter on the mound. Let's take a look. Steve, what do you think his strategy is going to be against this Dodger lineup?
You can watch baseball.
There's a swing and a liner towards first. And a fantastic catch made by Bell. Defense changes the complexion that he does right there with that great diving stop.
He had great preparation as that ball was going to the plate and allowed him to react quickly and get the jump on the ball.
Here's the lineup for the Dodgers. John, who do we keep an eye on?
Well, if you're looking for a big hit, look for Mark Ellis. He has an unbelievable knack for coming up huge in the clutch and driving in big runs for his team. There's guys on base late in the game. Mark Ellis is the guy they want up.
Ball. And Lenskov, no luck with that pitch upstairs.
You know, you're not going to win your division without being a force on the road, and that's exactly what the Giants were in 2012. Funny thing about it is they were actually a much better offensive team when they played on the road.
Ball two. Crawford will lay off a low pitch. And just back to what Steve was saying about the Giants being better run producers on the road, second best offense in all of baseball when they were the visiting team.
Well, I think that just tells you how hard it is to hit in that big ballpark in San Francisco. And then when these guys
swung on, hit in the air to right center, and Pence is there, roams over, puts it away. Now let's take a quick look at the Giants and how they line up defensively. And scouting those fielders, John.
Well, from day one in the big leagues when he arrived, Buster Posey's been a leader on the field, and that's what you want from your catcher. He has to take charge of a pitching staff, but he also has to take charge of the running game, and he has done that as good as anybody.
And Matt Kemp up. Just a .214 career batting average against Tim Lincecum.
And sometimes the pitcher just have the hitter's numbers, and that's the case between these two.
The pitch. That's hit foul by Kemp. Oh! And it's 0-2. Kemp will be careful. They'll try and K him.
You don't get the same kind of movement on the two-seam fastball when you throw it up in the zone because your hand's not on top of the ball. But that little bit of movement he was able to garner was just enough as he throws that up and in.
Ball. And Lindskum's pitch gets too close. That'll be taken for a ball.
Now he struggles with the changeup with two strikes, Gary. I'm going to pull the string right here.
The 1-2 pitch, ground ball. Crawford throws to first in time. That's three down. And a good half inning there, gone in short order in this one. Giants 4, the Dodgers nothing. We'll be looking to the leadoff batter later on in this inning, another A.B.